Hey everybody, good morning to you all. Shavua tov umvorach. I hope you all had a great Shabbat. We continue with the halachot of Hanukkah, and today we'll talk about part two of halakha in the Beit HaKnesset. So as we mentioned before, we have the minhag to light the menorah also in the Beit HaKnesset. And when the person will say the three berachot on the first night, he will still be able to repeat those same three berachot at home, because these are two different independent mitzvot. Unless he is by himself at home, then in this situation he will not say the Shehechiyanu, since he already said the Shehechiyanu in the Beit HaKnesset. Also vice versa, if he lit at home and then he goes to shul to light on behalf of the Kahal, he will also say the Beracha of Shehechiyanu, since it is for everybody who is there. Now a person who is Lo Alenu Abel in mourning, even within the Shiva, he's definitely also allowed, not just allowed, but he should light as a Ba'ala Bait at home, because he still has the same mitzvot than anybody else. In the Beit HaKnesset, we should appoint somebody else to do the lighting who is not Abel, because especially the first time we're going to say the Shehechiyanu, it may not be appropriate. Now, another detail about the halakha of the Beit HaKnesset is you will realize that we don't always light by Tzeta Kochavim, which is really the ideal time for the Hadlakat Nerot Hanukkah. We sometimes light even beforehand, before we need at least by Pelaga Mincha, between Mincha and Arvit. And the reason is pretty simple, because we want to make sure that people are going to light at home on time. We don't want to delay the Kahal to have to wait until Tzeta Kochavim to stay in the Beit HaKnesset and light there, because it's only a Minhag and the Mitzvah is really at home. So therefore, it would be okay to light a little earlier, as long as it's after Pelaga Mincha. And this way we'll perform the mitzvah on both ends. Have a nice and amazing day, and Shavua Tov to everyone.